Beloved, I greet you in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And I felt pressed in my spirit today, not really intending to do a devotional today, coming off of a somewhat busy weekend and busy period leading up to the weekend. But I felt pressed in my spirit to query today, how is your faith going? And I felt pressed in my spirit to share a real life story with you that I'm going to get to momentarily. But I challenge us this morning, when you find a love like the love of God, beloved, you can't just give up. You can't just walk away. Glory be to God. I'm sure that in your natural life, if you found somebody who loved you unconditionally, nothing that you ever desired, that person would deny from you. They met your every need. There wasn't one iota about them that challenged you, that caused you concern. I don't believe that any right-thinking person would just give up on that person or dismiss them. But I believe that they would want to cling to that person, hallelujah, Jesus, for dear life. I want you to see God in that light today. And that you don't give up on this faith that you have in this mighty God that we serve. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. The wonderful story of love. Hallelujah.
Wonderful story of love. Tell it to me again.
Hallelujah.
Wonderful story of love. Angels with rapture announce it. Shepherds,
Jesus,
with wonder receive it. Sinner, oh, won't you believe it? Wonderful story of love. Wonderful story of love.
Hallelujah. Wonderful story of love. Hallelujah, Jesus. How could you ever want to walk away from the love of the Lord? And I pray every day that He helps me to remain steadfast and unmovable. Glory be to God. In 1 Peter chapter 4 and verse 12, Peter records, "Beloved, think it not strange concerning the fiery trial which is to try you, as though some strange thing happened unto you. But rejoice, inasmuch as ye are partakers of Christ's sufferings, that when his glory should be revealed, ye may be glad also with exceeding joy." I titled this very brief discourse this morning, "How is your faith?" How is your faith? And The gentleman by the name of Burton Rieger, and I mentioned him in one of my devotionals already. He's writing on tough times, and I came across this story last night. He said there was this husband and wife there. A beautiful baby girl was born to this husband and wife, and the little girl had serious health issues, confining her to a wheelchair. Several years after the birth of this child, her husband died. She later remarried, and she got married to a wonderful man who struggled with depression, he said. Together they had a baby girl, and several years afterwards, a baby boy. Then sadly, her second husband died, leaving her alone with three children. The youngest daughter had such great difficulty with the loss of her father that she ended up in the hospital. The mother, shortly after the death of her husband, learned that she had extensive cancer in different parts of her body. He said, "I went by to see this family, though I was not sure I was up for the visit. The mother had been through much, yet she had a joy that radiated from her face." He said, "As I sat on the couch, I marveled at how she was praising God in the way He had walked with her. She had one daughter in a wheelchair, another in hospital, was twice widowed, and had a body ravished by cancer. It was an incredible privilege," he said, "to witness a person who had given God such control of her life, and by doing so had learned that real joy and peace comes not from being disconnected with God, but comes from being connected with Him." He said she had a freedom in her life many would envy, and find difficulty to understand apart from God. He said her courage and her appreciation of her Heavenly Father was humbling. Glory be to God. She was not happy about what she had been through in life, but there was a joy that reached deep into her very being. Hallelujah. He said he once heard a pastor say, "Joy is a deep sense that God is enough." Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Joy is a deep sense God is enough. It was amazing, he said, to observe the freedom that she had that seemed at odds with the troubles and the heartaches of her life. Beloved, how many of us would have given up if we had chosen that lot? And chosen doesn't mean you chose it, but how many of you would have given up on God if you had gone through as much as this believer in Christ did? And yet she was determined in her spirit that she was not going to give up on the God that she served. Beloved, I challenge us this morning. Think it not strange. This COVID-19 situation is strange. I know. It is causing, I tell you, the world to be in a kind of a turmoil. It's causing families, economies, nations of the world, almost in brought to a tremendous halt. It is strange. But I want to challenge us today that in the midst of it all, God is still who He says He is. He is still all in control. Hallelujah. I challenge you today, do not let the enemy fool you. But in the midst of whatever you are going through, I pray in the name of Jesus, that just like this pastor, you would realize that joy is a deep sense that God is enough. God has a way of meeting our needs. Look to Him today. I want to challenge you as I close this morning, as the Apostle Paul challenged the Corinthians in 1 Corinthians 15 and 58. I want to challenge you, beloved. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. Get busy for Him in this time and season. For as much as ye know that your labor will not be in vain in the Lord. Beloved, hold on for dear life to this wonderful story of love. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah.
Wonderful story of love. Though you are far away.
Oh, Jesus. How far does he feel?
Wonderful story of love.
Oh, Jesus, to some today.
Still he doth call today.
Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Calling from Calvary's mountain, down from the crystal bright fountain, in from the dawn of creation, wonderful story of love. Jesus provides a rest. Wonderful story of love for all the pure and blessed. Rest in those mansions above us with those who've gone on before us, singing the rapturous chorus, wonderful story of love, wonderful.
Hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus, I lift my brothers and sisters before you today. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus that you would look down upon them with mercy and with grace. Lord, I rebuke every wile, every scheme, every plan of the enemy, every thought that he's bringing into their mindsets today. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I plead the blood from the crown of their head, the blood of Jesus from the crown of their head to the sole of their feet. Lord, I pray that you would release your angelic host to encamp around them now in the name of Jesus. Father God, I declare today that the enemy is a liar. You said, Father God, that in your word you would keep in perfect peace those whose minds are stayed upon you. So, Lord, I pray today that they would look to you, the author and finisher of their faith, and that they would remain steadfast and unmovable in the name of Jesus. How is your faith today, beloved? I pray in the name of Jesus that it is getting deeper and deeper. Hallelujah, Jesus. In the love of the Lord. Don't give up. Don't quit. Hang in there. Hallelujah, Jesus. And see how God is going to come true for you. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace now and forevermore. Amen. God bless you. Have yourself a super day. In Jesus' name, amen.